Aintica ar ar son. Is nefa a anam. Avrora agus ashuraca. O war chimpel ar yosha agus nis fuija I gain. Boaitlum falcha a curroat in you. Higar daglish jes choga na wajin awira agus niv niklas. Iran law lucra calura agus dogus a sha. The Almighty has done great for us, great things for us. Holy is his name. Brothers and sisters from across our diocese and beyond, welcome on this day of joy, celebration, and expectation to the Cathedral of Our Lady Assumed into Heaven in St. Nicholas. Our cathedral has seen many great days over the almost 60 years it has stood on the banks of the River Corrib. But this day surely ranks with the greatest. The Holy Father has sent us a new bishop. We rejoice and are glad. Alleluia, alleluia. With joyful hearts, we gather to welcome Bishop Michael, who is the bishop of our beloved sister diocese, ancient and venerable Clonfert, to be our bishop too. The venerable rites in which we are about to participate are a channel of grace and goodness from Almighty God upon Bishop Michael, upon our diocese, upon our people here and far away, and upon our universal church. This afternoon's liturgy will take place in four parts. Firstly, the cathedral chapter. The parish priest of the cathedral parish and deanery representatives will greet Bishop Michael and welcome him to the cathedral and to the diocese before processing to the sanctuary. Secondly, the diocesan chancellor will read the mandate from Pope Francis, appointing Bishop Michael, and show it to the cathedral chapter and all those present. Thirdly, Bishop Brendan will lead Bishop Michael to take his place on the cathedra. Reverend Frank McGuinness will present Bishop Michael with the Book of the Gospel, saying, "Receive the Gospel and preach the Word of God with unfailing patience and sound teaching." Bishop Michael will then be presented with the crozier as a symbol of his pastoral office among the people of Galway, Kilmacdua, and Kilfenora. Fourthly, the celebration of the Eucharist for the third Sunday of Easter will proceed as normal, beginning with the Liturgy of the Word. Throughout this liturgy, whether you are present here in the cathedral or participating online, pray fervently, sing joyfully, and praise without end to our God and Lord for his goodness to us. We would ask that out of respect for the sacred nature of these rites, you would please refrain from taking photographs or making video recordings, and that you would now check that your mobile phones are on silent mode. How beautiful on the mountains are the feet of him who bring good news. Let us stand now, with minds and hearts renewed, to begin these sacred rites.
Thank you. Bishop Michael, we welcome you to your cathedral church.
We pray that God will grant you grace to proclaim his word and to serve his church in love, humility, and truth.
I thank you for your welcome, and I ask the prayers of the people of God, that I may be to them a faithful pastor and a true father in God, and that together we may serve to the honor and glory of our Lord, of Jesus Christ, our Lord.
On behalf of the Diocesan Chapter of the See of Galway, I will present this crucifix to you as a sign that you are now being entrusted with the pastoral care of the Church of Galway, Kilmacduagh, and Kilfenora.
May this water remind us of our baptism and lead us to share in the joy of the resurrection.
Thank you.
In anam an ahar agus an vic agus an spirit neif. Siachon liv. I invite you to be seated.
A fabul day. Keit falte roe ver fad an shah. Gahor dalglish within a jas togala. Agus niv Nicholas in aile tronuna. Agus mira falte freshen. Rivun pobl at a lean erlina. La mor dunyer fad pobl day. Joshus na galve kilvik du agus kilinurach an la shah. Ire nua taki in our mask, an chaspug mihalo divinan, mila mulla agus altu le dia. Na mura mor falte rot a aspig vihil, agus gama fada buon hu in our mask. Taim ansas the freshen falte uriv na hunadihe as chula foroshta sa joshe in yenach linbur sagart. Comailish na dini ta taka mar unadihe o furushti joshe chluin farta. Agus word sagart shu freshen. Ta guil nua, guil nis gwerin ariv, an nish idir winter chluin farta agus winter na joshe sha I barsan an tasbug mihal. Agus is banacht fubul an da joshe Un sokru nua sha sna hamanti in a mighty moit. Agus biach moit e guive shin in yov. Agus gamai raje un sokru shin go fobel un da yosha. My dear people of God, I am delighted to welcome you all this afternoon, both in person and online. To the Cathedral of Our Lady Assumed into Heaven in St. Nicholas here in Galway. We've all gathered to welcome Bishop Michael Duignan with deep joy and to accompany him in prayer and to celebrate this Holy Eucharist with him. I am delighted to welcome him amongst us as our shepherd for the foreseeable future. You are a gift for us, Bishop Michael, from the Holy Spirit through the Holy Father, Pope Francis. Today you assume the service of shepherd of God's people here in the Diocese of Galway, Kilmacdua and Kilfenora, as entrusted to you earlier this year on the Feast of Our Lady of Lourdes, February the 11th. Bishop Michael takes up the service as bishop here along with that of being Bishop of Clonfert. And so a very special welcome is extended to all who have come from the parishes of Clonfert along with your priests. As a neighbouring diocese, we welcome the strengthening of the bonds between us, represented by the fact that we now share the same pastor and shepherd. Bishop Michael, and the hope for the future of church and faith in both our dioceses that this new arrangement promises. I welcome also the people of our own diocese representing the 39 parishes along with our priests. Fáiltim go speisialta inniuv riv His Excellency Archbishop Jude Thaddeus Okolo, the Apostolic Nuncio to Ireland, who has brought us this good news and who represents the Holy Father here today. You have come, Your Excellency, bearing the apostolic letter of appointment from Pope Francis, which will be read for us in just a few moments. We are truly honored by your presence, Your Excellency, and all that that presence represents to us. We are conscious, too, of the news from the Vatican today that your term of office with us in Ireland is coming to an end. With your transfer to Prague as Apostolic Nuncio to the Czech Republic. You have been an assuring and friendly presence with us these past 5 years, traveling up and down the country, visiting all our dioceses, and innumerable parishes. We will miss you, but we assure you of our prayers that they will go with you as you assume your new mission in Prague. I have great joy, too, in welcoming Archbishop Seamon Martin of Armagh, the Primate of All Ireland, Dermot Farrell of Dublin, Kieran O'Reilly of Cashel, and Archbishop Emeritus Michael Neary, representing the new Archbishop of Tuam, Francis Duffy, who is leading his diocesan pilgrimage to Knock today and so cannot be with us. A special welcome also to Archbishop Michael Crotty, the Papal Nuncio to Burkina Faso and Niger in West Africa, and a classmate of Bishop Michael's, along with his other classmates who are with us. I welcome in a very special way Bishop Martin Drennan, my own predecessor here in Galway, and all the other fellow bishops who are with us too. Our gathering is very much enriched by the presence of many women and men religious and representatives of religious congregations, orders and new movements living and ministering in the diocese. I welcome representatives from the Church of Ireland, Methodist and Presbyterian communities, representatives from the Islamic community, along with people from all religious traditions and secular worldviews. Our gathering is enriched greatly too by having some people from Ukraine who are now living in the diocese, and we are very much praying for you and your country at this terrible time. Agus fáiltim go Criúil freisin roimh mear an gaileamh an Cór Leor Colette Connolly, along with other members of the city and county councils. Agus freisin, elected representatives of Dáilearn and Seanadéirn, and members of religious, social and cultural groups and associations. A very special welcome is reserved for Bishop Michael's mother, Mona, his aunt and godmother, Vera, his other family members and close friends. And we are remembering with him too today his late father, James. Bishop Michael, it is good for us that you are here and will be with us as shepherd and father of our diocese for the foreseeable future. Times are turbulent, and there are great changes and challenges in our world and in our church. But you are never alone. The Lord who has called you will never fail you, nor will Pobaldain na Dioshisha. Our prayers, the prayers of the people of God in this diocese, are already with you, and they will sustain you every day. My dear people and priests of this diocese, may I take a moment briefly then to thank you for your patience and tolerance, your constant support, friendship, and ceaseless prayer for me since I was transferred home to Galway as bishop 4 years ago. And for the wonderful and blessed 37 years as priest amongst you before I had been appointed Bishop of Achonry in late 2007. Today I have only the fondest memories, the goodness of people, the example you have shown me, the kindness and the calling forth, both here and in Achonry. I could never have imagined such a rich and blessed life. From my first day as priest to today, you have been my members and my teachers. You have revealed the face of God to me and the compassion of Jesus Christ. I thank you and will never cease to thank God for you. Agus beshiv chulala bio a wadis me gobuich im faidrachi. Fui chumirke muide maher goran taspid mihal agus shiver fad chulala bio a wadis shiv.
Let the apostolic letter from the Holy See be read.
Francis, Bishop, servant of the servants of God, to our venerable brother, Michael Duignan, hitherto Bishop of Clonfert, and Bishop-elect of the Ecclesial Community of Galway and Kilmacdua, in whose person the diocese are united. Health and apostolic blessing. Christ set us free for freedom, not that we again be fettered by a yoke of slavery, but that we may be servants of one another through charity. That we may reveal throughout the world the mystery of his grace, through which iniquity is turned to innocence and the old is made new, and we recognize the dignity of our nature, though corrupted in Adam, molded anew in him. Considering this goal of life in Christ and the foundation of pastoral ministry, and disposed towards the good of souls and the spiritual advantage of the Catholic Church, we are at the same time greatly concerned to know how our gifts may be adapted to our pastoral zeal for Christ. Therefore, with paternal love, we have turned our mind to the spiritual needs of the flock of Galway and Kilmacdua, which, being vacant at present, after the resignation of the last bishop, our venerable brother, Brendan Kelly, awaits with longing a new shepherd and moderator of its diocesan life. Reflecting openly upon the responsibility and activity you have discharged for the good of the Lord's flock of Clonfert, we have taken you into our consideration, venerable brother. You who seem endowed with the pastoral virtues and human gifts, which will render you suitable to fulfill this office. Therefore, having heard the advice of the Congregation for Bishops, and with the fullness of our apostolic authority, we appoint you Bishop of Galway and Kilmacdua, to which also the full administration of the Church of Kilfenora is attached, with all due rights assigned and appropriate obligations imposed. In addition, upon the advice of the same congregation, we unite the Church of Clonfert and the Church of Galway and Kilmacdua in the person of the Bishop, decreeing that you, venerable brother, be the sole and same Bishop for both dioceses. Regarding our decree, we desire that you inform the clergy and people of the ecclesial community of Galway and Kilmacdua, whom we exhort to welcome you as a respected father and listen to you as their teacher. Venerable brother, may you support this family by your devoted service, so that enlightened by the example of your sound judgment, it may be wisely and moderately enjoy all the good things of this world, and ever bear in mind that which God has bestowed upon his people, so that they may be attentive to their heavenly hope. Given in Rome at the Lateran on the 11th day of the month of February, in the year of our Lord, 2022, the ninth of our pontificate, Francis.
I willingly accept this pastoral office, entrusted to me by our Lord Jesus Christ, through his vicar on earth, Pope Francis. With the help of the Holy Spirit, and in cooperation with priests, religious, and people, I will strive to guide and serve the people of the Diocese of Galway, Kilmacdua, and Kilfenora, preach the gospel, and celebrate the sacred mysteries.
In the name of God, I invite you, Michael Duignan, Bishop of Galway and Kilmacdua, and Apostolic Administrator of Kilfenora, to take your place at the chair in this Church of Galway. May our Lord Jesus Christ watch over you now and forever. Receive the gospel and preach the word of God with unfailing patience and sound teaching. Take this staff as a sign of your pastoral office. Keep watch over the whole flock in which the Holy Spirit has appointed you to shepherd the Church of God. body high in excelsis stay. Exult forever, O God, in renewed youthfulness of spirit, so that rejoicing now in the restored glory of our adoption, we may look forward in confident hope to the rejoicing of the day of resurrection. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever.
A reading from the Acts of the Apostles. The high priest demanded an explanation of the apostles. "We gave you a formal warning," he said, "not to preach in this name. And what have you done? You have filled Jerusalem with your teaching and seem determined to fix the guilt of this man's death on us." In reply, Peter and the apostles said, "Obedience to God comes before obedience to men. It was the God of our ancestors who raised up Jesus, but it was you who had him executed by hanging on a tree. By his own right hand, God has now raised him up to be leader and savior, to give repentance and forgiveness of sins through him to Israel. We are witnesses to all this, we and the Holy Spirit, whom God has given to those who obey him." They warned the apostles not to speak in the name of Jesus and released them. And so they left the presence of the Sanhedrin, glad to have had the honor of suffering humiliation for the sake of the name. The word of the Lord.
In shinnin the lichtators na flash, agus ertala, agus fuihala, agus awarge, cholmed gulade ra, gramala, agus unod, agus glode, agus coat contate on the heese a rechide, agus gunun fan the shirichta, agus durst na cherahule, amen, agus glecht na shanari, agus ringishad ada, briher and sirna.
The Lord. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Jesus showed himself again to the disciples. It was by the Sea of Tiberias, and it happened like this. Simon Peter, Thomas called the twin, Nathanael from Cana in Galilee, the sons of Zebedee, and two more of his disciples were together. Simon Peter said, "I'm going fishing." They replied, "We'll come with you." They went out and got into the boat, but caught nothing that night. It was light by now, and there stood Jesus on the shore, though the disciples did not realize that it was Jesus. Jesus called out, "Have you caught anything, friends?" And when they answered no, he said, "Throw the net out to starboard, and you'll find something." So they dropped the net, and there were so many fish they could not haul it in. The disciple Jesus loved said to Peter, "It is the Lord." At these words, "It is the Lord," Simon Peter, who had practically nothing on, wrapped his cloak round him and jumped into the water. The other disciples came on in the boat, towing the net and the fish. They were only about 100 yards from land. As soon as they came ashore, they saw that there was some bread there, and a charcoal fire with fish cooking on it. Jesus said, "Bring some of the fish you have just caught." Simon Peter went aboard and dragged the net to the shore, full of big fish, 153 of them. And in spite of there being so many, the net was not broken. Jesus said to them, "Come and have breakfast." None of the disciples was bold enough to ask, "Who are you?" They knew quite well it was the Lord. Jesus then stepped forward, took the bread, and gave it to them, and the same with the fish. This was the third time Jesus showed himself to the disciples after rising from the dead. The Gospel of the Lord.
On the cover of your booklets, you will see that we have gathered here this afternoon for my installation as Bishop of Galway, Kilmacdua, and Apostolic Administrator of Kilfenora. Some weeks ago, when I used the word installation in conversation with my mother, she simply replied, "Could they not have got a better word for it?" Installing something, that sounds like getting a new washing machine or a fridge freezer. While the word installation is rightly used to describe the technical and canonical aspects of today's ceremony, another less common but perhaps more personal description is simply the reception of the new bishop, or even the welcome of the new bishop. It is customary that this ceremony of reception or welcome takes place in the cathedral church, which takes its name from the Latin word cathedra, or chair, the place where the bishop sits, the mother church of a diocese. What a striking, majestic cathedral we have here on the banks of the Corrib, in the heart of the city. It has surely lived up to Bishop Brown's dream that it would be solid, dignified, and worthy of Galway. It stands as a testimony to the faith of the people of this locality, and a visible daily reminder to raise our minds and hearts towards God. I'm conscious of the passing of the years since it was built, and the fact that I am the first Bishop of Galway to be born after it was consecrated in 1965. Today's reception and welcome began at the great west door. As I crossed over its threshold, I could not but think that this is, in a very real sense, a threshold moment, a graced moment of transition from the past to the present to the future. I am both honoured and humbled to be formally received and welcome in this way by the priests and people of the Diocese of Galway, Kilmacdua and Kilfenora. Established by Pope Gregory XVI in 1821, Galway is the youngest diocese in Ireland. The first bishop was George Joseph Plunkett Brown. Coincidentally, before his appointment, he was the parish priest of my home parish in Athlone, and like me, was a priest of the Diocese of Elphin. In 1883, Pope Leo XIII joined the Diocese of Galway with the Diocese of Kilmacdua and appointed the Bishop of Galway Apostolic Administrator of Kilfenora in perpetuum. I am conscious that today marks yet another historic milestone for the people of faith in these parts. For as we have heard in his letter to us, Pope Francis has appointed for the first time one bishop to serve the Diocese of Galway, Kilmacdua and Kilfenora, and the venerable and ancient Diocese of Clonfert. This is a historic development, not just for the church communities in the parts of the counties of Galway, Clare, Mayo, Roscommon and Offaly that comprise the two dioceses, but also for the Catholic Church on the island of Ireland as a whole. Not only have we entered this threshold moment, but with the reading of Pope Francis' letter and the seating on the chair, we have already crossed over and our new journey together has begun. We set out against the backdrop of the first day of May, my favourite month of the year, when all of nature so vividly comes to life after its annual winter sleep. As a Christian people, we also set out on this journey together in the full light of Easter and with the hopeful message of new life and infinite possibilities echoing in our hearts. Our first port of call has been to sit and listen to God speak to us through the scripture readings of this Mass for the third Sunday of Easter. The gospel we just heard takes us out of the highly charged atmosphere of Jerusalem, back to the relative tranquility of Galilee. For Jesus and his first disciples, Galilee was home. It was the place where they had first met him where he and his message had captivated them. After the resurrection, Galilee was to become a place of new insight. There they were to come to the realization that the ordinariness of their humble lives had intermingled in an extraordinary way with the life of God himself. Peter announces, "I am going fishing," and the others follow. They spend all night out without catching even a single fish for their trouble. As morning breaks, a man on the shore calls out. He advises them to cast out once more, but this time in a different direction. In no time, the nets are full to breaking point. John cries out, "It is the Lord." Peter, overcome with excitement, jumps into the water and swims ashore. As the others pull in and unload the catch, Jesus invites them to come and have breakfast. With a flashback to Holy Thursday and a flash forward to our celebration of the Eucharist, he takes the bread and he takes the fish and he shares it with them. Such events mark a truly threshold moment in the lives of those early disciples. Not only do they rekindle their shattered faith, but they also bring increasing clarity to the belief that in Jesus, God himself in all his glory was lovingly present to humanity. However, this is not all. Those events of that first Easter ushered in a new sense among the early Christians that this transformed, resurrected Jesus was now really present to anyone who might turn to him in their hearts. This is not some fabricated idea from centuries past. Down through the ages, countless numbers of Christians have sensed in their experiences, in their prayer, in the sacraments and at Mass, that same Jesus alive and present to them. Deep in the recesses of their hearts, they have listened to his voice and received wisdom that has in many instances turned their lives around and helped them to achieve far more than they ever could on their own. Such friendship with Jesus enlightens us when it comes to the deep down questions of life. Why do we exist? How should we live life well? Where do we go when we die? Such friendship with Jesus has inspired generous hearts to work for the betterment of the least well off among us and to endeavor to transform ourselves, our families, our communities, and our world for the better. In the first reading from Acts, we see Peter and the apostles brought before the menacing Jewish authorities of their day. Their recent encounters with the risen Jesus seem to have totally transformed them from the confused, cowering, faltering, fearful men they were. They have a new energy, a new focus. It seems impossible to dampen the hope that has been enkindled in their hearts. Impossible to silence the good news they had to tell or to lock up their faith in Jesus Christ. By contrast, nowadays, at times you might be inclined to think that faith in God or friendship with Jesus or the living out of Christian wisdom is something that will soon be a thing of the past. For a variety of reasons, many no longer believe the message. Many of our parishes are struggling on so many levels to support a vibrant faith community. Despite the great work done by generations of priests,
religious and lay people. Now, at times, it feels like we have been out all night without a single catch. We can no longer ignore the fact that much of what the church has built up in Ireland over the last two centuries is crumbling before our eyes. The more and more I see, the more and more I am convinced that much of our infrastructure, our systems, our pastoral practices that were beneficial in the past now hinder rather than help the life of faith. Here too, we stand at a threshold moment. Inevitably, there will be a sense of genuine mourning in letting go. But these Easter days tell us that out of such death comes new hope and new life. Perhaps the Lord is asking us to throw our nets out in a different direction, in the direction of a new and profound re-evangelization of ourselves. As individuals and as a community, perhaps now we need to focus on rediscovering the living presence of the risen Christ among us. We need to experience again the joy and excitement his message gives. We need to rekindle our confidence in its ability to transform our oft broken lives and transfigure our suffering world for the better. We need to sense anew that this joy, like all joy, is a joy that calls out to be boldly talked about and respectfully shared with our fellow travellers on life's journey. It is clear that in the future, we will be a smaller faith community. But with the help of God, we will be a more faith-filled, vibrant, welcoming, grounded community. A faith community that is aware of our individual human weakness, while at the same time ever striving to overcome such weakness with the merciful, healing help of God. A faith community that lives the message of Jesus in a way that better speaks in equal measure to the lives of our fellow women and men. A faith community that builds bridges, not barriers, and that reaches out in compassion to aid those who find themselves in need. A faith community that is less afraid of those who see life differently from us. A faith community that finds its appropriate place within Irish society, and an Irish society that finds a fair place for people of faith. A faith community that is filled with the sound of young voices and that is inspired by their idealism and urged on by their energy. A faith community where people, priests and bishop, walk side by side in a truly synodal manner as companions on the great adventure that is the Christian way of life. I thank you, the priests and people of the Diocese of Galway, Kilmacdua and Kilfenora, for your generous welcome. I thank you for receiving me and accepting me as a travelling companion on the journey of life. I pray and I ask you to pray that I, though flawed in so many ways, may with God's help do some good among you. Pray also that we will renew our confidence in the presence of the risen Lord with us on the way. Pray that we will discuss, dialogue, and discern together what he is calling us to do in our today. Pray that we will commit ourselves to action and work towards a future of new possibilities and new opportunities. As the month of May begins and we bask in the warming, hopeful light of these Easter days, let us not forget, as St. Paul reminds us, to give glory to God, who working in us can do infinitely more than we can ask or imagine. St. Nicholas, St. Coman, St. Fachana, St. Brendan, Our Lady Consoler of the Afflicted, pray for us. Amen.
Credo in unum Deo.
God our Father, you are our shepherd, and we, your flock, are a source of joy for you. You watch over us and provide us with the nourishment that satisfies our minds and hearts. Longing to live lives worthy of your gifts, we pray to you for wisdom and for convictions based on the gospel.
Pope Francis and the whole Christian community, that as we journey on the synodal pathway, the Holy Spirit may renew the Church and enable her to become a powerful leaven for peace and justice in the world. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear us, we pray.
Taspach o Divigon, gomaish sé bainithe le léirgas ar céard atá dia a thuairt dún, agus céard atá sé gíri ar in san am seo. Gnáim seo I muid le céile gur ab onan ar aontú le tail dé agus tuairthis is fearr gur féidir a bhronna ar an domhan seo. Guím muid don tírne.
I hear.
O Lord, hear us we pray.
Those seriously ill and those who care for them, for families devastated with worry and loss, that the Lord's healing, comfort and strength may be close to all. We pray to the Lord.
O Lord, hear us we pray. O Lord, give us your love.
For families that our efforts to journey with each other may make each home a place of acceptance and safety, that we may give each other the freedom to be and become ourselves. We pray to the Lord.
O Lord, hear us we pray. O Lord, give us your love.
For peace, that compassion and love may take flesh in all who are involved in the war in Ukraine, that the illusions of control and prowess may be replaced by what endures, generosity, welcome, and the embrace of the other in their need. We pray to the Lord.
O Lord, hear us we pray. O Lord, give us your love.
Let us pause in silence for a moment for each one of us to bring before the Lord private intentions of our hearts at this time. We pray to the Lord.
O Lord, hear us we pray. O Lord, give us your love.
Dóibh siúd tá imithe ar líon na fírinne. Guím muid a cathairithe do na mrá agus na fir a chálacha le COVID-19. Mar aon le nár gcórsan, ár muintir, ár gárda, a líon tathir bhaile dó féin iad. Go mbainis siad amach an bheitha thiarraí. Guím muid don tírne.
Father, protect us, your flock, against all danger and all evil. As you watch over us, grant us what we most need at this time, to keep us faithful and joyful in serving you and each other. We make this our prayer through Christ our Lord.
Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God the Almighty Father. Receive, O Lord, we pray, these offerings of your exultant Church, and as you have given her cause for such great gladness, grant also that the gifts we bring may bear fruit in perpetual happiness through Christ our Lord. Amen. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, at all times to acclaim you, O Lord, but in this time above all to laud you yet more gloriously, when Christ our Passover has been sacrificed. For with the old order destroyed, a universe cast down is renewed, and integrity of life is restored to us in Christ. Therefore, overcome with paschal joy, every land, every people exults in your praise, and even the heavenly powers, with the angelic hosts, sing together the unending hymn of your glory as they acclaim. You are indeed holy, O Lord, and all you have created rightly gives you praise. For through your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, by the power and working of the Holy Spirit, you give life to all things and make them holy, and you never cease to gather a people to yourself, so that from the rising of the sun to its setting, a pure sacrifice may be offered to your name. Therefore, O Lord, we humbly implore you, by the same Spirit, graciously make holy these gifts we have brought to you for consecration, that they may become the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, at whose command we celebrate these mysteries. For on the night he was betrayed, he himself took bread, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying,
Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. The mystery of faith. Therefore, O Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of the saving passion of your Son, his wondrous resurrection, and ascension into heaven, and as we look forward to a second coming, we offer you in thanksgiving this holy and living sacrifice. Look, we pray, upon the oblation of your church, and recognizing the sacrificial victim by whose death you will to reconcile us to yourself, grant that we, who are nourished by the body and blood of your Son, and filled with his Holy Spirit, may become one body, one spirit in Christ.
May he make of us an eternal offering to you, so that we may obtain an inheritance with your elect, especially with the most blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Saint Joseph, our most chaste spouse, with your blessed apostles and glorious martyrs, with Saint Nicholas, Saint Coleman, Saint Fakhan, Saint Brendan, and with all the saints, on whose constant intercession in your presence we rely for unfailing help.
And may this sacrifice of our reconciliation, we pray, O Lord, advance the peace and salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm in faith and charity your pilgrim church on earth, with your servant Francis our Pope, and Michael our Bishop, the order of bishops, all the clergy, and the entire people you have gained for your own. Listen graciously to the prayers of this family whom you have summoned before you. In your compassion, O merciful Father, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world. To our departed brothers and sisters, and to all who are pleasing to you at their passing from this life, give kind admittance to your kingdom. There we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory through Christ our Lord, through whom you bestow on the world all that is good.
Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Athenta and Slaniha dar droru, agus briher j dar jagas, tosha jemishnuk agan ara.
Oh,
Sirshin o gokolk in Piamidarta hirna. Thor duan go kinelta, shia con linarlin. Onus gomayamid lacunav the throkra, ser umbaka. Igoni agaslan on illeborch. Agashin exul leshandokus nefa. Agus lechakt ar slanihura Isa Chris. Hear ne Isa Christ the Dorch, the Daspel, Fogam Shiokon Agav, Tugam thee of Mohiokon, Na fake er or Bacchana, Akar Credge of Daglisha, Joni Shiokon a Horti, Agasia Into, Fui Morris Tull Latfain, Tossa O'Warren, Agasarialian, Three Hail Nasail, Amen. Shiokon Anchirna live Igoni.
Let us pause for a moment to pray for peace. And then let us bow to those around us, offering them a sign of God's, of Christ's peace.
Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, my soul shall be healed.
For the reception of the Eucharist here today, if you are now sitting here in front of me in the nave of our cathedral, and if you are sitting towards the edges of the seats, towards the sides, we ask you to come forward to a communion point at either side here, to your left or to your right. If you are seated towards the center aisle, there will be a communion point here at the gates of the sanctuary and another halfway down the main aisle. That's for those of you who are sitting towards the center, towards the main aisle. If you are on either side of me here at the side aisles or behind me, please come up the center aisle of your section and go to your left or to your right, depending on where you are sitting. Thank you.
God wandered in the desert in Israel, the glory of the Lord was with them. A pillar of cloud by the day, and a pillar of fire by night. After the temple was built, the Lord's glory filled the Holy of Holies. When the time was right, the Lord himself, in all his glory, came among us, Jesus the Christ. Death itself could not diminish his divine glory. He is risen and present among us, present to us in the Eucharist we have just received. Now with one voice, let us acknowledge, praise, and worship him. Let your glory fill this place. Let your
let your glory fill.
Look with kindness upon your people, O Lord, and grant, we pray, that those you are pleased to renew by eternal mysteries may attain in their flesh the incorruptible glory of the resurrection, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
I ask you to be seated for a few moments. I won't keep you long. What a beautiful, prayerful, and uplifting liturgy we have celebrated. What wonderful ritual and ceremony deeply rooted in our Christian tradition. Here today, the church in the diocese of Galway, Kilmacdua, and Kilfenora, and indeed the diocese of Clonfert, has gathered as one. Earth has been united with heaven. God has been truly worshipped, and we are better because of it. Mobuicus o cri, dovshud a gyrian liturgy, agus gachdina a glach parthon, na frastolia afran, agus na ministeri eixula a rechion ord aglish dan ocaid shon. Mila buicus, the Farran Chian Yu and Tahir John Gerd Acton, agus an slua a chudi leish. Mobuicus do Dorina McCarthy, an Tahir Martin Whelan, Marcella Fallon, agus Isabel Mulkern, in Ufagi na Dosha. Gaon buicus leish na Sarkastori, San Ard Aglish, Tim, agus Adrian, agus buicus freshen do Mwair na Hord Aglisha, Fui Stour Pascal Davini, agus buicus the Nori, agus gach dinna the Fuirin na Hord Aglisha. Special thank you to Mr. Ray O'Donnell, organist and director of music, the Galway Cathedral Choir, along with members of the Loughrea Cathedral Choir, under the directorship of Ms. Elizabeth Keane, for the wonderful music that has made today so very special. Thank you to Mr. Michael Vignoles on the Illan Pipes, and Mr. Paul Kyo for leading us in the communion reflection. Thank you to Monsignor Rabbit for all the work he has put into the organisation and oversight of today's ceremony. Peter, your input is greatly appreciated. Thank you to Father Dermot Hogan for his work in the area of communications. And thank you to him and all who took part in the beautiful vigil of prayer we had in Oranmore yesterday evening. Thank you to Dean McLaughlin and Canon O'Neill and the priests and people of the Diocese of Galway, Kilmacdua and Kilfenora, and the priests and religious working in the diocese present. Thank you also for your kind and generous welcome over the last few weeks. I would also like to acknowledge the priests and people of the Diocese of Clonfert and to thank them for their kindness and support leading up to today and during the last 3 years, made more difficult by the pandemic. A particular word of gratitude to Archbishop Jude Tadeusz Okolo, the Apostolic Nuncio to Ireland, for his kindness to me and his guidance of this whole process for the last while. Archbishop Okolo, I would be grateful if you might communicate to the Holy Father our thanks for his interest and fatherly concern for our diocese at this time in our history, and to assure him of our supportful prayers for his continued Petrine ministry. I'm conscious that today it has been announced that Archbishop Okolo will be leaving us and taking up a new assignment as Apostolic Nuncio to the Czech Republic. I'm sure all here would join me in thanking him for his years of service here among us and wishing him all God's blessing for the journey ahead. Gunyari an Bohr Lat. I must be one of the few bishops to now have three living predecessors. I would like to thank Bishop Kirby and Bishop Drennan for their continued kindness and wisdom and support. Goramahagoth a Aspic Brendan, Goramahagoth as Octan Falcha Creu, a Quirthu Roman Show, Augusto Kinaltas le Cupla Mianus. I do not think we should let a day like today go by without recording the debt of gratitude we owe for you and for your years of faithful ministry as a priest, as Bishop of O'Conry, and in these latter years as Bishop here in Galway. I would also like to acknowledge your contribution to the Irish Episcopal Conference, especially in the area of Catholic education and the Irish language. I am sure everyone here wish you a long, healthy and happy retirement. And I feel thankful that you will be there for me if I need some wise advice or even help with my cúpla focal. I would like to acknowledge the presence of my family and to thank them for their continued love and support and for putting up with me over the years. I remember in particular my father James, my grandparents, aunts and uncles who have gone home to God. I would like to acknowledge with gratitude the presence of the dames and knights of the Holy Sepulchre, along with members of religious bodies and organizations, new movements and faith initiatives who are present in our congregation today. Thank you to my many dear friends who over the years have greatly enriched my life. Friends from other Christian traditions, friends from other religious traditions, friends who are still friends, although we might disagree on many aspects of the church, and friends of no faith at all. I'm conscious that for the Islamic community, tomorrow marks the great festival of Eid, so I wish you Eid Mubarak. Finally, I very much look forward to visiting the parishes and priests of this wonderful city and beautiful diocese in the coming months and getting to know my way around. Please pray for me. Pray that I may make a good companion on the journey ahead. And remember, He is not here. He is risen. He has gone before you to Galilee. Níl sé anseo. Martá sé áirithe. De réir mar a dúirt sé. Tá sé dul romh go dtí an Galilee. Go raibh míle maith agaibh go léir.
Just across the road from our cathedral here, a new bridge is being built. But course, today is all about building bridges too. Today we build a new bridge between the new diocese of Galway and the ancient diocese of Clonfert. Today too is about building bridges of friendships and new relationships. And today, I know that I speak on behalf of everybody here in our cathedral and all of the people, religious and priests of our diocese, in congratulating Bishop Michael as he comes among us as our new bishop today. I also want to offer him and to assure him of our prayers and our support as he begins this journey of leadership and stewardship of our diocese for the years ahead. Bishop Michael, on behalf of all of us, you are most welcome again. I know that many of you will want to have a personal word of welcome with Bishop Michael this evening, and we'll all have an opportunity of doing that outside afterwards. At the end of our ceremony, we invite you to leave the cathedral by the door behind you. And when you do, we ask you to turn to your left, regardless of what door you exit through. Turn to your left and make your way around the building. We'll have some refreshments for you over here in this corner, outside. And when you get there, in a few minutes later then, Bishop Michael will be arriving to meet all of us there. So you'll have that opportunity of greeting him there. And I know that many of you will look forward to that. And again, thanks for your prayerful presence with us here in our cathedral today.
Today is the 1st of May. I ask you to pray with me now before this image of Our Lady. Our Lady, Consoler of the Afflicted, bringing our prayers and the prayers of the two dioceses before our Blessed Mother.
Thank you.
Peace be with you.
Bow your head and pray for God's blessing.
May God, who by the resurrection of his only begotten Son, was pleased to confer on you the gift of redemption and of adoption, give you the gladness of his blessing. May he whose redeeming work you have received, the gift of everlasting freedom, make you heirs to an eternal inheritance. And may you, who have already risen with Christ in baptism through faith, by living in a right manner on this earth, be united with him in the homeland of heaven.
Amen.
Gomani Gia Ilakok Tukshiv Ahar Mach Aga Spirit Leave. Amen.
Go and announce the gospel of the Lord.
Thanks.